Can we criticize issues in Hinduism?
Yes, indeed. You see, sometimes we feel, because we love our tradition and the other people attacking us, we should keep quiet and not comment about our own shortcomings. You may feel that it's the right thing to do. It's not the right thing to do. If there are serious flaws in your system, you must point them out and pull them out rather than let them continue to survive, because in case we are seen in a poor light. I tell you two or three issues that I have been kind of very strongly, you know, concerned about. One is this issue, for example, that they say, oh, we give equal right to women. They said this, but then in the rituals, suppose you have a marriage ceremony. The first part of the marriage ceremony is called kanyadan, donating the daughter. Now, daughter is not an object to be donated. Why don't you do kumardan? Let the bridegroom also be donated. So this is highly, highly discriminatory, showing women in a poor light as if they're objects to be passed on. That may be, you know, just sold off like that, you know, given away like this. So we are saying this idea of kanyadan is a serious mistake. We have grown out of it. We are giving equal rights to women. So dignify them. So don't say, if you want to do kanyadan at the wedding, then do kumardan at the wedding as well. That means give the son away as well. And the Hindus are so poor. I've been rubbing this into the Indian community in the UK for many years. And yet, because it's tradition, my parents won't be happy. What not happy? You are being treated like an object to be given away. How dare you tolerate this? So I'm telling the women, stand up for your rights and don't tolerate this kind of nonsense. There are other issues that bother me. For example, the one that I've been pointing out again and again is this. Because it's a wonderful law of karma, that cause and effect. It's simply law of cause and effect that all sciences are exploring, how things are connected. Now this law of cause and effect has been turned into a personalized form called the law of karma, suitable for individuals. The activity you do will produce certain results. It seems very sensible. And yet if you don't understand it in full complexity, it can turn very nasty. And this has happened to modern India. I'll give you two examples. First of all, if you don't understand the law of karma properly, when things go bad against you, they will all go bad against all of us from time to time, warning you. So when things go bad, we go in the corner and cry, oh, my karma is catching up with me. This is called fatalism. The law of karma never taught you things like that. He said a lot of things gang up. Your own contribution may be very limited. Other things gang up against you and push you in a corner and put you in a difficult situation, not because you deserve it, you've done bad karma. A lot of other things gang up against you and push you in a corner. The law of karma says when things happen like that, roll up your sleeves and come fighting and sort yourself out. This is the law of karma. But the Hindus understand only the fatalistic part. Look at them, they cry, oh, I deserve it. Oh, you don't deserve it. Get off and sort yourself out. The second part of law of karma, which is seriously misunderstood, is this idea that you'll find in modern India. The reason why modern India suffers from this huge gap between haves and have-nots. Some people don't have enough money to eat tomorrow, others are throwing millions of pounds for a wedding ceremony. So how can you have such a big have and have-not difference? The difference between have and have-nots in such a vast way. How can you allow that? How can a civilized nation allow this? Surely you must bring some equality in the human society. So why are we tolerating it, allowing it? Misunderstanding the law of karma. If you see somebody struggling in India and you tell your host, oh, look at this poor girl, she's starving outside your door. Oh, what should we do? You say, don't worry, Mr. Lakhani, her law of karma is catching up with her, let her suffer. We did some good things, let's go and enjoy. This is called indifference to the suffering of others, allowing this huge difference between have and have-nots in modern India. So these are the issues, for example, that I point out very, very strongly and hoping that these WhatsApp clips go to India and stir up the people. They are, I'm telling you, they're going worldwide, they're becoming viral. We must tidy up Hinduism and explain it in its proper manner, structured manner, rational manner, so it becomes effective rather than becomes counterproductive to what we are all about.